Yo, where to go on? So, this would be the third way to use somebody else in work for your music. Like I talk, everybody they pull inspiration from so many places, if they be artists, and as musicians, we always they pull inspiration from other people their work. Now, the third one I did want to talk about, which is the last one, the sampling somebody in song. Now, sampling will be compulsory, right? Sorry about that. Sampling will be compulsory. And what that they mean, we say, if you want to sample somebody in song, the person where they own the rights, the person where they own the rights to the song, you go fit decide, say, you don't use the sample, don't do it. That person go fit decide, say, don't do it. Or that person go fit refuse some. Or it could demand a very significant or huge amount of advance or money. Or it would take a sales percentage of the royalties or the money where you will make from the sample. Yeah, so Burna Boy sample Toni Braxton in song. The title of the song was "He Wasn't Mine Enough," and the song is sample "Take Make Be Last Last." Everybody go jogging, yo. So Burna Boy them sample Toni Braxton in song. Yeah, I mean. He also sampled Mace and Brandy their song, Sitting on Top of the World. So, samples be done, right? But if you know, so you could pay a percentage of the sampling you did do, and the artist go fee refuse, say, don't use my sample, don't use my song as a sample. So, everybody they do sample every time, like MF Doom, you know, in albums, Mad Villainy, so many samples from songs from back in the day, you know. And for you to be able to get somebody in sample to use peacefully before clear the sample. And what that means, we say if you contact the publisher of the original song and the composition, and if you reach an agreement before you go use the sample, don't feel so you go feel use anybody in song. It be Ghana way artists, somebody go feel release song, then some artist in voice in song way they inside they pick up or in beat, they pick up then they use because our system know they work. Our system know they work for uptown, developed places. The systems they work. You know, if you just use somebody in sample like that, they will sue the hell out of you. You understand? So before you go do that, if you reach an agreement of the usage of the song, and because the song where you want sample, it incorporates the use of the original song. So if you go look for the record label where they own that song so that they will give you the masters, then you go pull the thing from there. You understand? So if you find the original owner of the song before you go make a song sample, and if the work be very old, it'd be very difficult. But I mean, for rap, if you sample the record player from there, then they go, you know, they go pick some of the information and since then they go use some. You know, so that'd be the thing about sampling somebody in work. You know, be simple like that. The person could feel refuse you. Don't try sample anybody in work, in song. Or you feel say you could get away with them. One day, they could come at you. And so there are some websites like Tracklib, you understand? Then they find a way to create samples of the song where, you know, they already deal with the producers. They make sampling make easier. So if you go Tracklib, they feel, you know, you will figure samples of certain songs where you want, where it be already sorted out, where you go feel, you know, either buy or whatever, or you know, Spliced and BeatStars. You understand? Those platforms, they already get the samples for the song. So even when you use the beat, you buy beat for the, you know, some of the things, it be already sorted out. So yo, yes, the third way to use somebody else's work is sampling. But with the toxic, the sampling, they go feel refuse you. And make sure, say, you know, we go take or use somebody in sample where you don't get permission. You will have issues. The person will make the tear your song down. I think it was Roy Timmy in song or something like that. And who? Was it Mr. Drew? Mr. Drew do some song with Roy Timmy. They go report where they tear the song down. Don't feel, say, you go if you do anything where you like. People, they take people, they are samples for Ghana and nobody, they talk anything. This old high life legends, modern artists. So many of them. I didn't hear this Kwame Eugene and all those guys, Kiddy them. So they use old songs and re-sing them in their songs. And I think, I don't know whether they have the permission and they've paid for it. they've paid for the advance, because people take the advance before they allow you to use their samples, right? I don't know if they've done that, but if they haven't, the fact that they are doing it doesn't mean you go fit take somebody in song for a brochure from uptown and then you go use them and nothing will happen. You will have issues. It'll be very important. Big up, make I know what you think.